PRİSENCÓLİNENSİNÁİNCIÚSOL. We the stain the shoes and I will hold build the scene in a whole red maybe get the color boss dying. Chance and behind me get the cold, baby sustain yet with Joe. We the stain the shoes and I will hold build the scene in a whole red maybe get the color boss dying. When it's the same man's unicorn being seen, you know for time another judge of God, baby's a sham.
Finally on the move in our brand new Nissan Lambo.
Lambo because we paid it in Bitcoin.
First things to do, gasoline.
Yes.
So we're looking for a gas station.
The tank is empty.
That accepts our Bitcoin and maybe a coffee too.
A coffee would be great.
Hola señor, una pregunta por favor, ¿aceptan Bitcoin?
No.
Hola señor, una pregunta rápida, ¿aceptan Bitcoin? ¿Es posible pagar con Bitcoin? Perfecto, gracias.
Gracias, señor. Gracias. Esta es la compra, ¿no? So Chivo doesn't work inside, so we have to pay from the Chivo here outside at the gas station. The company is the same.
That we are not driving, Satoshi is driving us.
What does it mean? It means that when you travel with Bitcoin, you can plan everything as much as you want, but something is gonna happen and you're gonna be forced to change your plan.
And you never know when you're gonna end up. And this is the case.
Guess where we are? We are right in front of the Santa Ana volcano, right in the middle of the national park of Cerro Verde. What happened? We were driving when we got a message on Twitter from a Bitcoiner, local Bitcoiner, a Salvadorian Bitcoiner. He told us that there is this hotel that it's super Bitcoin friendly.
They will make Bitcoin meetups here, so it's very well known in the Salvadorian Bitcoin community.
He said this was a beautiful place, that we should check it out, and
there we are.
Here we are.
The last part of the road was a little bit bumpy. We almost broke our Nissan Lambo the second day of its life.
Yeah, we got scared.
But that was so
But we made it through, yes. Once we arrived here, oh my gosh.
Heartbreaking.
Oh my gosh, guys. The view is stunning. It's not a real hotel, it's more a bunch of bungalows right in the middle of the nature, beautiful. Our bungalow has a huge window and right in front of it, bang, the volcano of Santa Ana. It feels like...
You can touch it.
It's incredible. And we are on the top of a high mountain. The view on the valley down there is beautiful. Yesterday night, the sun was setting and there was this sea.
Blanket of clouds.
Incredible.
Beautiful. We can confirm this is a super Bitcoin friendly place and bring us weather.
Oh yeah, it's very chilly at night.
You're the cold maze, say one prison calling Ensenáincíúsol. Alright!
Santa Ana is by far our favorite city here in El Salvador and we're always happy to go back.
It is beautiful, smaller than San Salvador and therefore much more livable, but also much more authentic. In the early 1900s, during El Salvador's golden age, it was the economic and cultural capital of the country, by far the richest city. Giving it this leadership was the coffee industry, which had, and still has, its epicenter here. All around the city, in fact, stood the most famous crops of the precious beans.
Santa Ana will also allow you to experience the real El Salvador, the one less touristic.
Let's be clear, being a Bitcoiner and coming to this country to just hang out in San Salvador and Bitcoin Beach, it's like going to Disneyland and saying you have been to the United States.
Don't get us wrong, these are beautiful places and you have to see them. But El Salvador is a beautiful country and there's much, much more. Put yourself out there, get out of the comfort zone of Bitcoiners.
Explore! Going into places like this, for example, can put a foreigner like us a bit in discomfort. We know that, but we can assure you that if you enter with a smile on your face, you will receive only smiles in return.
You will think that if, as we proved in our last vlog, few people accept Bitcoin in the nation's capital, here, in a provincial town and in the middle of a street market, it would be an impossible task. And instead, you have to keep in mind that it is a lower class that often has a true wallet in the pocket and they don't want to lose a client.
Don't be intimidated. Ask politely. These people will surprise you. Often you will be their first Bitcoin transaction.
And it will give you an incredible joy.
Yes. ¿Está bien?
Sí.
Te vaya bien. Gracias.
Mexican tortillas. Paid in Bitcoin. Here. At the market. At the street market.
Perfecto, son 5 dólares. Ma una pregunta, ¿se puede pagar con Bitcoin? ¿Tienes una billetera de chivo?
Sí.
¿Sí?
Sí.
¿Se puede pagar con Bitcoin el ticket para mañana?
Sí.
Dos, por favor.
Tickets for the Theater of Santa Ana.
National Theater of Santa Ana.
Tomorrow at 6
p.m.
Yes, it's the super famous Ricardo Arjona.
We paid them in Bitcoin. Cerveceria Paris Hilton.
Mira, amore.
Cerveceria Garibaldi.
Amore, we have to try. If they accept Bitcoin.
Of course they do. Sex work is work.
Yeah, but we need evidence. We have to do it for the science.
No.
She's no fun.
Baby.
Crapapelada la fai turtei, ghinada minga, i soffradei. I soffradei han fa la frittata, ghinanda minga, al crapapelada.
Crapapelada la fai turtei, ghinada minga, i soffradei. I soffradei han fa la frittata, ghinanda minga, al crapapelada. Crapapelada la fai turtei, ghinada minga, i soffradei.
Crapapela, crapapela, crapapela, crapapela, crap, shedip dip dida, shedip dip dip dip dip dip dip dip dip dip dip dip dip dip dip dip dip dip dip dip dip dip dip dip dip dip dip dip dip dip dip dip dip dip dip dip dip dip dip dip dip dip dip dip dip dip dip dip dip dip dip dip dip dip dip dip dip dip.
Da minga i soffradei. I soffradei han fa la frittata, che non da minga crapa pelata.
Born in El Salvador, my family was born in La Union. We come from La Union, from a little town called Nueva Esparta. Yeah, the civil war, you know, we found the path to move to the US, but I never forget, you know, the relationship with all the green, all this running in this farms. And for one day, my aspirations were always to come back. Well, the spirit of all this project is that we want to show and illustrate all our proof of work from seed to cup, which is what we're trying to do. And before El Salvador, we had the cacao as the currency. That was our monetary unit back in our ancestors. And for some reason, it continues to be in that way, because coffee is like cash. It goes from hand to hand, after water is the most consumed product. So what we try to do is allow the Bitcoin, the spirit of Bitcoin, allows us to eliminate the financial and commercial intermediaries, because it allows us to go from here at the farm, where we're able to control the quality control we export, but we also, for those of Bitcoin friends are around the globe, particularly in Europe and the US, who wanna buy a fresh bag of coffee and you know, buy with a connection of Lightning payments, we get the money in instantly. Adoption has been kind of, you know, like it's gaining traction in a slow way, but at the same time, it's nothing is overnight. The banking system everywhere, but particularly here, has been a very awful experience. And the banks are represent a major, major bottleneck for producers. With Bitcoin, it facilitates commerce directly. We roast coffee, we give it the origin here, and people in Europe are buying via Lightning payment gateway. Same thing in the US. So all of a sudden the money is instantly received, whether it's a Sunday evening or whether it's, it's 3 a.m. in the morning, it doesn't matter. 24/7, it helps us because the velocity of it is easy, it's fast and effective. The good 20 to 30% in less than a year since we started.
In Bitcoin.
For every cup of coffee in the fiat world that people consume, the farmer, we get 3 cents, and we don't get it immediately. We get it like many months later. 3 cents per cup of coffee. With Bitcoin, we get almost 100% of that.
Mm.
rovinò lungo la china. Solo chi ha un destino rovina. Non voglio che l'impuro ti colga. Ti darò a una rondine in volo. Niente è come sembra. Niente è come appare. Perché niente è reale.
Of course we are late to our show
at the center in the theater of Santana,
at the National Theater in Santana. Hola señor. Gracias. Gracias. Gracias señor. Was gorgeous, amore.
So
what do you
emotional.
What do you think? Eh?
I almost cried.
Ah, that absolutely a nice concert, a tribute concert to Riccardo Anjuna, guys. Who is Riccardo Anjuna? Now maybe you are disrespecting someone. Who knows?
You're right.
The theater was full of fans.
That was super fun.
So, what do you expected? Something different?
No, that's exactly how I expected. The theater was very great.
Gorgeous.
Pretty small.
Yes.
So it wasn't like this huge concert.
Now sing me the song you like the most.
Riccardo Arjuna.
Com'era quella? Cerca me! Cerca me! Tu sueño! Cerca me!